1821, Indiana's state capital was moved from Corydon to Indianapolis. The reason it was moved was because Hoosiers thought it was too far south to remain the capital. Then by 1825, government business was taking place. But before they moved the capital, the General Assembly set up a commission to select the new capital. That's how we have Indianapolis as our state capital.
1861 to 1865, the Civil War. The Civil War started in 1861 and ended in 1865. This was called the Civil War. The war started because some people wanted to abolish slavery, but others wanted to keep slavery. Factories built war equipment to the Hoosiers who were fighting in the war. 25,000 or more Hoosiers died in the Civil War. President Lincoln was elected president, and he told Emancipation Proclamation to give freedom to the people who were dealing with slavery.
In 1906, the United States Steel Corporation built a steel mill on the shore of Lake Michigan. The company started a new town for its workers. On the Grand Climate River. The town was named after Albert H. Gary. The chairman of the board of the United States Steel at the time.
Between 1910 and 1930, many African Americans moved from the south to the north.
The African American population doubled.
South farms were going through hard times, and north needed factory workers.
There were a lot of unfair rules around this time.
The 19th Amendment is passed. The 19th Amendment, women did not have the right to vote. Women in Indiana worked for suffrage.
The Civil Rights Act of 1964 made suggestions in public places. This act was created because many African Americans were facing discrimination. Suggestions were an issue, and people decided that change a product of the civil rights movement led by Martin Luther King.
2001, terrorist attack. The United States at home, the U.S. Foundation, terrorism is use of violence to promote a case to control something, like a plan. On September 11, 2001, President Bush made up a Department of Homeland Security to help prevent terrorist